Today we're going to be installing a communication card, the BACnet card specifically, on this CGAM. So we just got this thing installed, a couple of weeks ago. And we're just getting all the little fine-tuned things. They didn't originally have it set up when we ordered the chiller for the BACnet card, and then decided later to proceed with that so it'll communicate with the automation system. So that's what I got going on today. There's your module, just a communication interface. We've got to get it set in and get it programmed. I believe this will require binding. I do have the service laptop here. Yeah, so this will require binding because you can see right here it's got this SW1. That SW1 is an indicator. That's what we'll use with the magnet to activate this board so that we can identify it and bind it in. And then we'll get our comm wired in, which is these two wires right here. This is going back to the automation system. We also, I need to look at the interface here and try to verify which one of these ports that they wanted this installed in. So whether it's 1A14 or whatever it is, I'll be able to verify that once I look through the diagram. We also just replaced this flow switch. So this has gone bad. We put new seal tight, got a new flow switch in. So this functions as the start stop for the chiller. So what the automation system here does is it fires this pump, turns the pump on. When the pump fires through a relay, then it closes that paddle switch. And that paddle switch closes the start stop circuit for the chiller. So now we have an independent flow sensor that's built into the chiller. The old RTAA, I don't believe it did. It was all coming through the same setup. Anyway, so we got that fixed because the old sensor was just stuck in a closed position. So that pump wouldn't even have to be on, and it was closing, which that's going to cause alarms and issues with this particular chiller because it's not going to like that. It will give you issues if it sees that it has a start with no flow. It's going to see that as a pump alarm. All right, so what I want to do is we're looking for the controls schematic. Get a panel layout. All these are the power. These are not the control. Okay, here we go. So we have our high pressure cutout, compressor, fault, compressor, condenser fan, condenser. That's the interlock, pump, evaporator, condenser. One of these boards, emergency start stop. External chill water communication board. There we go. Optional. This one's going to plug into J2 to go back to the comm, and it's got the link is the termination. And then this one says J2 is our termination with J11 is our link. So we'll look at this. Okay, so these are where our communication to the tracer is going to hook up. It's at J2. And then we should have J11. This is where the communication, these plugs plug into. So deducing it, we have we're gonna be using the A115 point with J2 and J11 to plug this in. So 15 is way down there, right behind this. That ain't gonna work. So what we'll probably do is come up to, well, that's crazy, it goes 14, 16, 15. The problem here, they have a really old version of Summit. This is BACnet and it does not have compatibility to run a LON network. This does. This is LON compatible, so they wanted, they need to have LON to operate their system. So I'm going to put this in. Instead of moving this stuff around, I'm just going to go ahead and probably set this right here at A14. It's not going to be in exactly the right spot, but any chiller tech working on this ought to be able to understand that, hey, those two blue wires is communication, and it's close enough. Something I do really recommend is this Klein. This is the 15-in-1 HVAC edition. I really suggest y'all having one of these. These are not my main screwdriver, but with all the specialty bits, I always keep it with me, and it's so handy. In this particular case, we've got these little Torx screws, and I don't have to make a trip to the truck. I don't have to do anything. I've just got this bad boy right here. Whip it out, put in what I need, move on. Getting our service tool set up here. So this is just a serial adapter port. You can see the little pin guard's missing, but that's okay. This will plug through this bottom hole into the controller. It just lines up. Pretty straightforward. We're gonna go to local, setting up. Now we'll have to go into a binding view, and this will shut the machine down to do this, so just be mindful of that when you're going through this process. To do the binding, you will need a magnet. I have had really good results with the Malco tips. Just pull the head off, that magnet works perfectly. Now once we get into here, we will need to go up to our views, and we're going to go down to a binding view. I do have a full video just specifically on how to go through a binding process on doing any kind of a sensor or anything. So at this point, the machine would be shutting down. It has to launch into a binding application, and you're going to see your display will change into what they call the converter mode. It's going to take it a minute to fully go through everything, pull all the sensors, and see everything that is bound in this system. So you're just going to have to be patient with it. We're in the binding view. You can scroll through. You can see we actually don't have an unbound device. And so what that'll mean is I actually got to go into the configurations on this programming, and I'm going to have to tell it that it's going to have that device. But you can see the BCIR is that BACnet module interface, and you can see, if you want to verify that here, you can see the BCIR right there. But what we will be looking for is the LCIC. That's the one we need to bind for that particular module. While I'm waiting on that to load, one of the things that drives me crazy about laptops is the batteries suck. But this is where I do heavily recommend getting an inverter for your truck. So I've got a Duracell 800 watt inverter, and it sits behind my my front seat console. Got it plugged into the back seat, cigarette lighter plug. And I don't actually use the 800 watts. It's actually oversized for what I would typically use it for. You could actually get a full like 1500 watt that would wire straight to your battery, and you could run like a vacuum pump or something off of if you needed to. But right now, I've got it plugged into it. There is no power out here at this plant, so it kind of sucks. I don't really feel like putting a dead man on right now. But power here to charge the laptop, so I can do this out of my truck. All right, looks like we're good. So I need to get into configurations, BAS interface. Okay, so I got two different options here. I have LON. I have LON talk with Modbus, or I have just LON talk. And to be honest, I'm not 100% sure which this one is. See, it's comms revision H comm. Let me see if I can do some deducing. It just says COM 5. Okay, well, we're going to be using LON anyway. So I'm going to go with the safe option, and I'm just going to select just the regular Lawn Talk LCIC, and then I will I'm going to load the configuration. It'll make that update, and then I'll have to go in and it could do it on its own. So yeah, it's going to restart everything. It could automatically bind that. I've had that happen before, where you don't actually have to manually do it. And I see we didn't have a status light before, we do now, so that's actually a good sign. So like I said, it may do it on its own, but if it doesn't, that's fine. I can go in, I can manually bind it, and this will enable the lawn card to where I can get it bound and they can run the automation. So it brought me right back to the binding view as soon as it finished the configuration. So you can see now we have the LCIC, COM5, extension, revision 1. I'm just going to leave. You still see the BCIR module on there, and that's okay. I'm not gonna mess with that. It's not going to hurt anything. So we're going to go to bind. And then before I hit yes, take your magnet. I'm going to come right up here to that switch 1. The little green light turns on. I don't have to touch it to the board. I just have to get it close. Then go yes. It's going to think about it. And it's set. What I should be able to do is come out of binding view now. Now that we're fully connected. And I'm just going to go through, double check some of the parameters. Make sure I don't need to make any other adjustments. And then at that point, it's up to the automation to come in, finish tying in and setting up all their points and communication. I don't have an option to fully rerun this whole wire fresh, and I really hate it. You're not supposed to extend wires like this, so the automation company might come back later and redo that themselves, and that's perfectly fine with me. In the meantime, I am going to put a extension. So I just put a small jumper piece and I'll wire these together here. Configurations, everything looks good. Card seems to be doing its job at this point. I've done what I can do. The automation company will have to come take care of the rest. We are showing chiller is in stopped. We'll move over to auto. Run inhibit, which is a good thing. So the other day, waiting for BAS communication. Yeah, chillers stopped by external source. Okay. So the other day, this was going straight into auto mode, even though the pump was off. And that was because that wasn't doing right. Let's see. We got a chiller LCIC software mismatch. Use BAS tool. Actually, I guarantee, I wonder if they've got to come in and just configure it on the automation, and that's what's giving me that error. I can find out and verify though. Let me do that before I take off, because I don't want to leave this wrong and then they come try to set it up and they can't. Alright, I was correct. I did go in and verify, and the manual for this car does specifically state that the automation team will have to come in with what they call a rover tool, and they'll have to flash the specific software that they need on that card. So they'll have to come in, they'll take care of the rest. My part is done. It's installed, it is configured to the machine. There's absolutely nothing else I can do other than just make sure it turns on, which honestly, until they're not even worried about running it until they get the automation and everything completely set up on it. So yeah, that's our next step. Appreciate it, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. NTT, take care of your family, take care of your spouse, spend time with your kids. Other than that, I'll catch you on the next one. Hope you all enjoy.